mountain, great is the Lord and greatly to be praised.
Oh, yes. Amen.
In the city of our God, in the mountain of His holiness.
Yes.
Amen. Let's sing it to the Lord and rejoice in it.
See the things that you would have us see.
Yes, you are.
We
humbly thy will be done in Jesus' name. Yes. Amen. And you may be seated.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
What a privileged people we are to have this time of fellowship around the Word. We have a great subject today that we want to delve into. And our text is a simple text. It's an utterance made by the seventh angel. And it is this, he said, it's our Lord up there.
Amen.
And I'm referring to this picture that was published in the Life magazine. Yes. And I wonder this morning if Peter, James and John sat in this meeting, what their comment would be on such a text as this. I wonder this morning if the Apostle Paul was in this meeting, what he would say about a text like this. It's our Lord up there.
Amen.
Let us stand as we read the Word of God from Philippians chapter 2, verses 9 and 11. We read together from the Word of God. Wherefore God also hath highly exalted him, given him a name which is above every name.
Yes.
That at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow. Of things in heaven, and things in the earth, and things under the earth. And that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Yes.
To the glory of God the Father. God bless you. You may be seated. And here we go with a number of quotes, almost 40 in number, pertaining to this great text that we have. And you know, there's great controversy among the message people pertaining to this cloud. Over the years, I've heard comments. One says this and one says that. And in the past few years, there have been even more comments made on YouTube. That's why we have ventured into YouTube to put these messages on the internet. Brother Perry Green from Tucson, Arizona has a segment on YouTube called My Personal Opinion of the Cloud. My personal knowledge. Of the cloud. Believers.com have challenged some of the statements of Brother Branham and said, well, we can prove that it's a Thor rocket missed from a rocket. This pastor says this, and another pastor says that. But we have the utterances from the seventh angel, and he made a real statement pertaining to this cloud, and he said, it's our Lord up there.
Amen.
What are we going to do with it? Number one, let's read. Look what we've seen in this day. The quickening power has come to us to open the seven seals. What a privileged people we are this morning, viewing that again. But so blessed,
amen,
to see this glorious light.
Yes.
The truth pertaining to the second coming of Christ. It all lays in the opening of the seals. Number two, when the seven seals was opened, that opened the entire Bible. Number four, when that seventh angel sounds out, every mystery is over. There's a major fulfillment of prophecy there. Number five, but he promised in the last days, in this age, that every hidden mystery in the Bible would be revealed. It happened in the days of the voice of the seventh angel. Number six. Now you remember the voice said, go to Tucson. Remember the mystic light.
There it is. Right in front of the pulpit.
Remember the mystic light in the sky. Life magazine published it. Science magazine published it. Weatherwise published it. This mystic light was recorded in these three magazines.
Number seven, listen carefully.
In that, they didn't know what it was, and we knew. Just look at it this way, and
here's our text coming up.
It's our Lord up there. What is it that he was talking about? visionary. Visions were breaking forth. Visions were occurring. He was moving in a supernatural realm. And a major event was imminent. Something was about to take place.
The most sublime thing in the Holy Scriptures was unfolding. Sirs, is this the time?
And he cried out. And he preached that message under great stress and strain. And he said, is this the sign of the end, sir? Is this the sign of the end, sister? Is this the sign of the end, brother? Something major is fixing to take place. And in that great message of, sirs, is this the time, there were three major questions. I want to give them to you this morning. Number one, here's the question, sirs. Is this the mystery of the thunders that will bring back the headstone? You know, the pyramid never was kept. The headstone is yet to come. It's being rejected. Could it be, brethren, sisters? Could it be both male and female he was addressing a message to? Could it be? Could it be that the headstone, Christ, the stumbling stone, the stone that the builders rejected, could it be that he's going to return? He said, I'm asking you, sirs. The second question. Will this be the mystery that would open up? That would bring Christ. Bring a power to the church. I sat this whole week studying on this power. It's coming up in one of the future messages. Will this be the mystery that will bring a power to the church? And number three, he asks again, listen to the question. Will this be the time when it will be again? Behold the Lamb of God. Those three questions. Great questions he presented to the people. Could it be, brother, sister? Number 13. Late in the 20th century now. There was a 20th century prophet on earth. And in his message, sirs, is this the time? He said, where are we at, sirs? What's all this about? I'm asking you. But nobody could doubt that in that message there were seven dreams and seven visions. There was prophetic utterance. And prophecy only benefits believers. Amen. 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 A prophet making prophetic utterances is only for the believers.
Amen.
Numbers 12, verse 6, let me read it to you. And he said, hear now my words. If there be a prophet among you,
remember last week, who is the I?
The Lord will make myself known unto him in a vision, and will speak unto him in a dream. So all these dreams and interpretations laying in the seventh seal is only for the believers. You will find out one of these days what these men have been dreaming about. You all know, I know what it means, but just wait until it will be more in season. preachers say that he will return one day in a return ministry to open the seventh seal. I have never, ever, ever, ever heard of such unscriptural nonsense. He said, when God has finished me, I'll be leaving you for good.
Yes.
But the seventh seal, Brother Ashley, it's never been opened. It's never been fully revealed. It's never been made known. The seventh angel had something different to say about the seventh seal. Or number 14, the seventh seal, he said this. Here's what it is. He's telling you. Here's what it is. The Lord showed me a vision one day about 10 o'clock in the morning, or one morning. And I come and explain it here that I had seen it. Didn't know what it was. It was a constellation of seven angels. We'll remember that. You'll get it on the tape called What Time Is It, Sir? Well now, listen. That is exactly what you see now.
Amen. Yes. Thank you, Lord.
The seventh seal was the exact fulfillment of the prophetic utterances made in Sirs, Is This the Time? Now listen, brother, listen, sister. 3 years ago, what time is it, sirs? 3 years ago, this mystery was a prophecy. What time is it, sir? But now, it's history.
Amen?
It's past.
Yes.
Are you reading with me?
Yes.
The promise is in process. Did I say something wrong? What did I say wrong, Brother Paul? Read it out.
The promise is fulfilled.
Brother Steve Cockney, what did you say?
The promise is fulfilled.
Brother Ashton?
The promise is fulfilled.
The promise is fulfilled!
Amen.
Amen!
Yes,
amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Get that, Eagle Abbey! See, that comes under the inspiration. Amen.
Amen.
In the rank of those preachers who believe the second coming is a process. He said it's history, it's past, the promise is fulfilled.
Amen.
How can a process be history? Think of it. Amen. The cloud, all the comets are flying, the preachers are talking everywhere about the cloud, questions have been asked, one says this and one says that, but it doesn't matter what any man, mortal might say. What matters is what the seventh angel said pertaining to the cloud. And he said, it's our Lord. take brethren that doesn't have the message and want to follow this, take sirs, what time is it? That's where the eagles go, brother. See, vultures cannot follow the eagle. Amen?
That's right.
They cannot see it's our Lord up there. Vultures can go so high, then they go blind. Number 17, I'm reading you a direct quote. We're going over the things that were spoken by the seventh angel, and he said, oh, you men in other lands, when you hear this tape, can't you wake up, my brother, or does it blind you? It blinds vultures. Would you throw it out and call it false prophecy when it's vindicated right before you? By the world, by the time, by the peoples, and by the Holy Spirit who wrote it. It's vindicated, both naturally, spiritually, and materially. Everything that he said is fulfilled and proven. The promise is fulfilled. It's our Lord up there. The seals are open. It's revealed to us.
That's true. Amen.
What did the seventh angel say? This is what he said. The same one that appeared to Moses in the burning bush.
Amen.
The same one,
hallelujah,
that appeared to Paul on the road to Damascus.
Amen.
The same one had his picture published in Life magazine. And who dared to dispute the vindicated prophet of God? Woe unto you. Woe unto you. Let this pulpit be a monument to the fact that the second coming of Christ has taken place. Number 18. Listen. 1954. Before this great advent, he said these words in number 18. He said, he don't come to earth on the next coming. We're just caught up to meeting in the air.
Hallelujah.
I've got a cluster of quotes coming in the next couple of weeks pertaining to that. Number 19. Let me tell you something. Are you going to listen? Let me tell you something. It's our Lord up there. Let me tell you something. Just let me drop this into your heart. There will never be a Jesus set foot on this earth until the church done raptured and gone. Don't get your comings mixed up.
That's right.
Don't place the third coming as the second coming. Number 20 says this, the Gentiles, they come out of the church ages.
Amen.
The Gentiles goes to meet him in the air.
That scripture, see?
Listen, brother, Jesus of Nazareth, amen, is now the King of Glory, and he had his picture taken and published in Life magazine. one in threes and sevens.
Amen.
All right, you ready? Let's go. An eagle is the strongest bird we got. Most powerful.
Okay, there's your power coming. Amen.
Some of their wings stretch 14 feet from tip to tip. He can take and fly so high that if any other bird tried to follow him, he'd disintegrate. Feathers would fall out of him and he'd come apart. If a hawk tried to follow him, he would die. He'd suffocate. He can't get into those spheres that an eagle does. Oh my, are you an eagle this morning?
Amen.
Brother, this is a no-go zone for vultures. Amen. This is a no-go zone for any other bird. This is eagle food. Amen. Oh, can you feel the presence of the Lord? Amen. Look, now we're into the age of the eagle. So whereas Jehovah Eagle is, great eagle, the same anointing on Messiah.
Yes.
The question is, what is the anointing? How many people ever see Benny Hinn on television? He takes his coat off and he swings it around and blows it over the people and they fall to the floor. And he says they are slain under the anointing. Aha! Elijah the prophet didn't say that.
Amen.
The Pentecostals say it's shaking. It's jumping, it's screaming, it's talking in tongues. They shake and slither through all kinds of emotional things. But the question is this morning, are you anointed? Amen. With what? The same spirit that he was anointed with. Ah, let's look at it. Number 26. See, this shakes a lot of people. Number 26, some people get the wrong impression of what the anointing is. Did you ever think of that? Are you listening? What did he say? The anointing is not emotion. The anointing is the supreme power in control. Like knowing exactly what and how. Amen. And how can you know exactly what and how in this age if you refuse to receive the word spoken by the seventh angel of Revelations 10:7? Jesus said, the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. John 6:63. Hear me? He anoints his beloved bride with the word.
Amen.
He pours his word upon her. Oh my. And remember, when the eagle finally comes, brother, this gets deep and this gets rich. See? I've always thought to myself, how could I preach anymore? I've got nothing more to preach on. This week I struck some great truths. And remember, when the eagle finally comes, it'll be 0.01% that'll listen. It's the eagle age. Show me one church where the song leader gets up, starts a meeting, and the chairs are empty. Amen? Sure. Oh, how terrible is that? No, brother. That fits the pattern.
Amen.
Amen. Eagles, you find them one at a time. You ever see a flock of eagles flying in the sky? Amen. Just one here, one there, and one on the other side of the earth.
Amen.
Amen. Number 27, just like the day of the lion or the ox or man. It's the eagle time. It's the anointing of the hour. It's the time that we're living in.
Amen.
And this morning we know that 0.01% have the genuine Holy Spirit anointing.
It's the eagle age that gets the word.
Yes.
And the revelation. Amen.
Number 28. Got a good message next week. God help us. Let's just remain humble. Let's just remain at our pulse. Number 28, God will do in 1 year what all theologies failed to do in 2,000 years. Listen, are you listening? You wait,
amen,
till the anointing
of the word.
You wait till the anointing of the church really strikes home to that faithful little remnant. Listen, did you get that? After the doors of the Gentiles is closed, it's so small that it goes right over their heads and they don't even know it's happening. God will anoint the church after the doors of the Gentiles is closed. Number 29. The sharpest eye there is an eagle. After Sirs, is this the time? After the visitation of the angels? After going out west for it? Amen. The story is told that Brother Branham visited some people and Life magazine was laying on the table. The sharpest eye there is an eagle. And his eye fell upon this high ministry cloud.
Amen. Hallelujah.
He picked the book up, he wanted it, and a voice said to him, turn it to the right. It's our law up there.
Amen.
Good messenger.
Yes.
I'm enjoying it. Okay. Number 30, that is, if he's a true eagle, he will understand the message of the hour. If he's a true eagle. Amen. So what scriptures have we got for the eagles of this day? Isaiah 40 verse 31 says, but they that wait upon the Lord, don't be hasty. Don't jump into the millennium when it's in the future. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. Amen.
Yes.
They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
See, 31. Patience is Holy Spirit virtue. Patience. So many lack patience in this hour. Scripture says, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. See, brother, you can't manufacture anything. You can't create anything. You can't create a revival. But they that wait upon the Lord shall be strengthened. Every day you can become stimulated by what events be made clear by prophecy.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Look, number 32. Coming to an end. I've been enjoying this privilege of reading these quotes. Amen. Amen. They've been a blessing to me. I trust they're a blessing to you. But look at number 32. They that wait upon the Lord. Let's just get that type changed. And we'll carry on. Read it clearly now. Read it with me. Look at what's transpiring in your life. Become stimulated by it. Number 32. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like an eagle. And we pray, God, that you will give us that mounting up power.
Yeah.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
Did you ever look at it? Did you ever study it? The mounting up power. That's rapture material, brother.
Hallelujah.
The power will come to the church that will lift her up. She'll be able to ascend up. She'll raise up with mounting power, right? Look, number 33. Put this one in your pocket for the week. That's the eagle mounting up, going up. in the rapture. It's not in the Bible. The word means caught up.
Amen.
Going up. That's the eagle mounting up, the going up. Way up till you can see what? The coming of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If you're an eagle, you can get up here.
Amen.
Amen. You can glide around this day and night.
That's right.
Amen. It's our Lord.
Yes.
Up there.
Yes.
Amen. Look, study these quotes. You can go home and build them, and this is just the foundation. Study these quotes. After you've listened to this, my friend. After you have had the privilege of reading and hearing these quotes, what are you going to do? What is your conclusion? Are you going to run quickly and ask your kind old pastor to explain it? Are you going to phone some message guru? Are you going to consult some theologian? I know Brother Brown said this, I know Brother Brown said that, but I can't understand it. You've got to ask the Holy Ghost, amen. Alright. Who are you going to ask about all these things? I wonder if we were privileged this day to have Brother Branham walk through that door and sit in the meeting. I wonder what he would say about all these words. All the parables that he has spoken about concerning the eagle and the eagle age. I'd like to consult him. I'd like to say, Brother Branham, what would you say about all this? Do you have something to say? He has a good quote that'll fit just into that. Number 34. Brother Branham! Oh, how I would love to talk to you. Brother Branham! Do you got a word to say? Have you got something to say? In a meeting he said one time, I said, I sure have. I said, brother, are you listening? These brethren become so earthbound till they can never soar up to see. Thus saith the Lord.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Ooh, that's a strong one.
Yes.
Amen. 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 Amen glory.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Brother, let us stand, brother. Let's turn to 208. And we'll sing that lovely hymn. Let's walk in the light. The beautiful light. Jesus, the light of the world.
Amen.
Amen.
Light of the world.